Hi, my name is Peter from URender. In this video, I will show you how to use the ambient occlusion methods in URender. First, let's talk about one thing that may be a little bit confusing. Direct light is that kind of light that is caused by light sources like point light, spotlight, area light and infinite light and is directly illuminating your objects. Ambient light is caused by light bounces after the direct light is hitting a surface for the first time. This is done by global illumination, spherical harmonics or just a simple ambient light source. Many users understand ambient occlusion as some kind of darkening effect that has to be multiplied over the entire image. But that's not how ambient occlusion works in real life. Ambient occlusion does only affect ambient light and not direct light. That means, if your scene is only lit by direct lights, you won't see any ambient occlusion effect at all. So let's open any kind of model and set up a very basic light setup. Create a spotlight and parent it under a null by pressing Alt-G. Move the spotlight along the Z-axis and adjust the rotation of the null. Assign a URender light tag and set the shadow mode to soft shadows. Also adjust the outer angle if needed. In the render settings, be sure that URender is set as render device and activate ambient occlusion. If you now render the image, you won't see any ambient occlusion at all. So we need to create an ambient light source. The easiest way to do that is to set an ambient light color in the render settings. Now we see ambient occlusion. Setting an ambient light color illuminates the entire scene with a constant amount. Sometimes you would need more visible variants, so for this case you can use an HDR environment map and activate Enable Diffuse IPL. The Diffuse IPL does the same what an ambient light does, but it uses the environment map for calculating its illumination based on spherical harmonics. You also can use ambient color and diffuse IPL at same time if you want. To give a little bit more control, you can use the occlusion slider to adjust the amount how strong the ambient occlusion affects the IPL. Now we have set up our basic light for the scene, let's have a closer look to the ambient occlusion methods. We have the ground truth and hemisphere ambient occlusion. Both methods are screen space techniques. Let's start with the simpler one, the hemisphere ambient occlusion. By increasing the radius, the area of darkening the ambient light gets larger. Power sets the strength of the occlusion. More samples increase the quality, but needs more render time. The hemisphere offset can be adjusted if the ambient occlusion looks offsetted. But take care when using very low values to prevent unwanted effects at edges. Altogether, the hemisphere ambient occlusion gives a smooth result and is easy to handle. The disadvantage is that this method can have problems when geometry is visually overlapping other geometry that has a certain distance in 3D space. This edge is quite away from the inside objects, but it's darkening the area although the radius is set low enough. Especially this kind of problems solves the ground truth ambient occlusion. This method also gives a more detailed result. It is darker, so you could decrease the power a little bit. The maximum range can be used to limit the radius. The Use Faster Preview filter in Live mode can greatly increase the performance, but may cause some flickering artifacts when moving the camera. So make sure that it is deactivated when rendering final results. When activating depth peeling, the precision of areas that are overlapped by geometry increases. This can be further improved by activating include backfaces and by the depth layer count. If we switch between the methods, we can see quite a large difference. To sum up, the hemisphere ambient occlusion gives a smoother and faster result, but is not so good for small details. It also can cause occlusion on areas that should not be occluded. The ground truth ambient occlusion gives a more detailed result and is more precise by using depth peeling for the costs of render time. Thanks for watching.